One of the things that happened to the Prophet ﷺ when revelation came to him, it was like a bell. Now a bell is reverberation. It's dawi, dawi. If you look at the word kun, and I learned this from a great musician, but I thought it was a very interesting, he was a famous oud player from Nubia, Hamza Alauddin. Because he said Allah began existence with kun, and he said that the ka is a cutting sound, which is true, it's used for cutting. In fact, in Arabic, many words that have cut are relate to cutting. And in English, we even use cutting to cut. So ka is a cutting sound. And then noon is a vibratory sound, kun. And so he was saying that existence comes from nothingness into being. So it's literally cutting the nothingness, and then the noon is the reverberation of existence. And one of the things that we know about existence is it's all reverberating. Like physicists tell us, everything has a resonance. Everything is resonating. And so resonance is dawi in Arabic, dawi. And the Quran, they talk about the Quran resonating. That the Sahaba كانوا يقرأونه كدوي النحل, like the reverberation of the bees. And one of the things about reciting Quran with tajweed is that you're forced to do these sounds that you normally don't do, which creates these resonances and affects you, because these things have an effect on you. When you recite the Quran properly, your whole body begins to resonate. Yasin. It's there. The sound itself is power. The sound is power. There's power in the sound itself. One of the interesting things about when you say something, that a proposition, somebody will say, bring your proof. What lawyers always do if they're good is they always establish their proofs before the proposition. So they give you all the reasons, and then they have their summation, which is to tell you why. Because they want you to rationally come to the conclusion, and then they'll add stories in there to get the emotional content as well, because they know that emotion's important. But they will give you the rational, and then they bring you the proposition. Now, you have to understand an oath. Because one of the things about modern people is they don't know the power of words anymore. I'll give you an example. In this country, who knows Alexander Hamilton? Alexander Hamilton was the Secretary of Treasury under Washington, right? How did he die? In a duel with a man called Aaron Burr, who had been vice president. Isn't it interesting that we had a vice president in this country who killed the Secretary of Treasury in a duel? I mean, America, the beautiful, it's amazing. I mean, could you imagine them doing that now? Maybe they should. Solve some of the problems in Washington. You know, I challenge you to a duel. I demand satisfaction. You know, Glenn Beck, I'd like to challenge him to a duel. I mean, these people have to know that words have meaning. That you can't just say things and not think that there's no meaning attached to those things. When you disparage the honor of people, when you vilify human beings that you have no knowledge of, and you say things about them and who they are and what evil they've done, they've had no trial. Like Imam Luqman in Detroit. What trial was he given? He's condemned. There's a jury and a judge and an executioner. Really? Nobody, there's no uproar about that, because he's a poor man. He's an insignificant man. He's in an inner city in the worst part of America that looks like a war zone. And people don't care about people like that. So they can go in and just gun a man down who was a Navy SEAL, served his country. And what's the charge? Fencing stolen goods? This is how you deal with people that sell stolen, but they didn't even steal the property. This is how you deal with people that fence stolen goods? You raid their place of worship and let a dog out on the person and then gun them down when they shoot the dog in self-defense? But who cares, right? It's like these people in Cleveland. It's like these women in Cleveland. Who cares? 14 women, convicted rapist, sex offender. But who cares? They're just poor people, right? Who cares? Even though people were complaining about the smell coming out, calling the police for months. No, words have meaning. If somebody calls for help, you should help them. There's actually haqq al-inqadh in Islam, that people have a right to be saved, no matter who they are. Whether they're Jews, Christians, Hindus, Buddhists, it doesn't matter. Words have meaning. People disparage people's honor all the time. There was a time when people would actually demand satisfaction because honor meant so much to them. What did the founding fathers write when they wrote there? We pledge our lives, wealth, and sacred honor. Sacred honor. Honor in Arabic is shahama. It's very similar to the English meaning of honor, an honorable person. He's an honorable person, a man of his word, a woman of her word. That's what words are about, and that's why we don't even understand oaths anymore. There's books in our tradition written on how to get out of oaths. That's how important people... Now we just say, wallahi, 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 and nobody thinks about what wallahi means. It's unbelievable how people use wallahi now. It has no meaning. Wallahi ya akhi ana qutra. Wallahi ana. Why are you swearing an oath? It's a big thing to swear an oath. I used to tell Arabs I was born in a town called Walla Walla, which is true, and they would say, Walla Walla. So I'm Walawi. The man from Walla Walla. So people don't understand oaths anymore. And that's why, you know, Herodotus, the great Greek historian, said, of all nations, no one takes the oath more seriously than the Arabs. This was centuries before Islam. Of all nations, no one takes the oath more seriously than the Arabs. If an Arab gives you his word, you know, my father said when he was young, he's like in his 80s, but he said he remembered a saying, I'd rather have an Arab on his word than a contract. That was a saying that people had about Arabs. Like Arabs were people of their word. And that's why to swear an oath is not an insignificant thing. When Allah says, Wal Quran al-Hakim, to the Arabs, this was a big thing. To swear an oath that you are a messenger of God. Innaka lamin al-mursaleen. There, it's the answer to that oath. You are. Surely, verily, now you have tawkeed. Because he could have said, Wal Quran al-Hakim, anta rasul, anta mursal. No. Innaka, verily, indeed, surely, an emphasis. And then la again, to use it again. That you are lamin al-mursaleen. This is, I mean, we don't understand modern people. It's sad that we've lost this access. But this, when the Arabs first heard this, even the Jahili Arabs would be, it's power. It's power. It's power. It's innaka lamin al-mursaleen. You know, this is real.